Here we are in episode 19 of the Simple Success Podcast. This is financial life coaching from a happiness perspective. Coaching happiness. When you change you, you change everything. Last week, we talked about initial public offerings or IPOs. This week, the pod is about 35,000 decisions a day. No wonder we get tired. Various internet sources estimate that an adult makes about 35,000 remotely conscious decisions each day. And compare that to a child's 3,000. That's some serious decision making. About 2.5 decisions every second. On the other hand, I learned recently that the average 4-year-old laughs 300 times per day, while the average 40-year-old takes 2 to 3 months to laugh that much. Coincidence? Maybe. You will decide to keep listening to this podcast. See what I did there? This number may sound absurd, but in fact, people, we, make 226.7 decisions each day on just food alone, according to researchers at Cornell University. This probably factors into the reason why Steve Jobs always famously wore a black turtleneck and jeans, because he didn't want the 35,000 decisions rattling around in his brain to include what to wear today. You and I have been given a free will and a multitude of choices in life about what to eat, what to wear, what to purchase, what we believe, what jobs and career choices we will pursue, how we vote, who we spend our time with, who will we date and marry, what we say and how we say it, whether or not we would like to have children, what we will name our children, who our children will spend their time with. And believe it or not, even more stuff. These daily decisions add up to 35,000 things, remember. Talk about decision fatigue. Did I say thousands of decisions? Yeah, I think I did. Each choice carries certain consequences, good and bad. This ability to choose is an incredible and exciting power that we have, but it also uses energy, and quick decisions are often difficult decisions. Choices carry good and bad consequences, so you shouldn't be surprised to learn that when we choose, no pun intended, to turn something into a habit, we not only remove a major decision from our task list, but we also ensure predictably positive results. Where does this statistic come from? Well, some research indicates that it comes from psychologist Daniel Kahneman. I don't know if that's true, but he and his former partner, Amos Tversky, certainly did a lot of great research themselves, so I'm happy to go with it. The point here being that doing this and doing it repetitively on a daily basis is no less important in investing. Now, let's be clear. They're not all life-changing decisions or even decisions that we will remember. Little stuff is included, like, should I get out of my chair and get a glass of water? And so I ask you about your long-term future decisions. Focus on those. The little stuff will take care of itself when you do. We are most effective when we don't spend lots and lots of time on decisions that have very little impact. Don't let time be taken away from important and possibly more beneficial decisions, like investing for your future. Don't let hindsight be blinding. Let foresight do that instead. That's the kind of game changer we all need. Hello, everyone. This is John with the Simple Success Podcast. Financial life coaching from a happiness perspective. Because we know you want to show us some serious love in return for the tremendous benefits you get from us, please head over to https://anchor.fm/simplesuccess. That's one word, simple success, whack, support. There, you can choose from a $9.99 per month doer level of support, a $4.99 listener level, or a basic intro level of just 99 cents per month. That's not much when you compare it to a stockbroker, right? And this is so much more sensible. To leave us a voice message, which just might see the light of day in a future podcast, go to https://anchor.fm/simplesuccess. Again, one word, simple success, whack, message. I won't repeat those links because weird. And anyway, show notes. In that spirit, today's episode is 35,000 decisions a day. Once upon a time, our heroine, Sophie Stevens, set about to make a decision. She was aware of the idea that we make 35,000 decisions in a day, but it didn't matter. What mattered is what she was thinking, this particular decision. And it was the most important thing ever, in anybody's life. Not just hers, anybody's life. Her epiphany? She realized she could make things easy and skip the bad choices. People who make things more difficult for themselves rarely, if ever, prosper from doing that. Lots of people make lots of decisions, bad decisions this way, and it doesn't matter if they back them up with posts by email. Sophie knew, like all successful people know, that the good she would get out of this wasn't more available to her than it was to anyone else. Not her friends, not the average person, not me, not anyone listening to this podcast. Just like you don't solve a math problem by gathering all of the possible answers and letting them try to prove themselves, you don't make good decisions by considering every possible outcome before becoming a leader and making simple decisions. You have to take some action in addition to knowing about taking action. Take control of a couple of decisions at first and focus on changing those couple. Make them count. The good, which will be revealed in our financial decisions, is overwhelmingly positive. And more about that wonderful day right after the break. In this Simple Success podcast, as well as in our webinars and masterclasses, we are very, very much going to want to hear your story. Well, to be real, I mean in future episodes of the podcast's webinars and masterclasses. This means you. Your participation is critical to our mutual simple success. It's important to know how you think, what you've thought, what you've tried, and what you've been unsure of trying. As we told you at the beginning, and as you also find in the show notes, we have ways you can contact us. It involves a special link where you can leave us a voice message, which just might see the light of day in a future podcast. We may have an email address for you as well in the future, and we'll let you know when that happens. Together, we're going to make it great. We're going to do what even we didn't think possible. We know a lot about you already because we know ourselves. For example, we know that you know how to listen to our podcast. We also know that you probably know how to subscribe. The reason every podcast asks you this is because when you subscribe, you automatically download all future episodes of that podcast. This means better rankings, more attention from advertisers, and more money. And that means more and better stuff for you. So your motivation is simple and easy. Subscribe today, wherever you get your favorite podcasts. Oh, and don't just try to subscribe. There is no try. There is only do. Remember, this is financial life coaching from a happiness perspective. Right after this, we'll explore some more important details you should know. But for now, use your imagination to help create your story. Let's get on with how to overcome this kind of problem. What to do and when and how to do it. 35,000 decisions a day. We make 35,000 decisions a day. What do we do about that? What's our call to action? Can we make all 35,000 decisions just go away? Maybe 30,000 of them? Please? We know that's not how it works, right? That's not exactly a proper analysis. We can chase that rabbit all the way up and down the trail, but instead, we're going to identify just one decision. One decision that we find ourselves making on a routine basis. And as we find that working, we can add a second decision. And as we find that working, we can add a third decision, and a fourth, and a fifth, and beyond, and each of them will be an effective decision. As with all my lessons, the emphasis is on patience and repetition, not shocking yourself, not with the significance of the decisions, and not with the volume of decisions. Let's go back to work on action step one. Identify one decision that you make over and over. It can be from the list above, focusing on what to eat or what to wear. It can be brand new, like, should I brush my teeth? Should I brush them now? See how decisions add up fast? If you want to stretch yourself with something that's such a basic thing, you don't even realize it's a decision, don't even realize it's another energy level, try writing something with the hand you don't normally use for that. Yes, believe it or not, every single day you decide to write right-handed, or if you're in your right mind, as the old joke goes, you decide to write left-handed. It's become automatic, but it's still a decision. Don't believe me yet? Try writing something with that, air quotes, other hand. Then do that again, but write it backwards this time. Watch, no, be hypnotized as the level of responsibility increases. Okay, phew, mental energy is good, but quote, simple, 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 unquote. Back to the teeth brushing thing. No, wait, back to the financial connection. Make your decision-making process simple. Find a first investment or a first new one. All of us have different taste buds, as they say. Get it going, put real money into it and do it today or this week. Do it in a specific time frame. I'll give my subscribers until the end of this month. Just leave a voice message timestamped on the day you heard this, and that will be your month. We're changing the way we look at things, and remember, that's good. Also remember, this is financial life coaching from a happiness perspective. Coaching happiness. Everyone listening can head to that voice message link in the show notes to record a voice message for a future podcast. Next week, we're going to look at another concept, and that is, we respect your time. As before, that got picked for me by my topics randomizer, so you know I'm not prepackaging this stuff, but instead making it relevant, so we can all, me included, learn how to do this right. We're going to bring that into the world of investing, and it's going to be a great episode. But for now, remember, happy Naked Gardening Day. I mean, all you need to do is practice, after which you'll get good. Gracias por escuchar. A la prochaine. For this Simple Success podcast, the Techno King is John C. Brandy. The Seagull example, Shola, Salako. Fact checker, Abraham Lincoln. French consultant, Virginia Mitchell. Media expert, Favour, Obasi-Ike. Psychologist, Sigmund Freud. Rabbit hole advisor, Dr. Marg, Perrott. Sound designer, Gugliemo, Marconi. Spanish consultant, Cameron, J.K. Brandy. Videographer, Alfred, Hitchcock. Audio props go to Les Paul. Inspiration to Napoleon Hill, Earl, Nightingale, and Bob Proctor. Also, we have a website, and you can subscribe to this podcast. You can even send us a video, audio, or text message. But of course, you'll have to head to the show notes, either on your phone or on the web, to actually get links and stuff. Finally, you can find us on Podmatch, where we consider guests for this pod, as well as consider guesting on other people's pods. And really finally, the music for Simple Success comes from the song Cute by the artist known as Bensound on freesound.org.